Tonight I'm feeling Cleopatra, Joan of Arc, Queen of Arts, yeah. Pack modeling. Hi! So, for today's vlog, I would like to take you to a wonderful Egyptian tour, which primarily focuses on fun facts about Egypt, geography, people and culture, and tourist destination. And I don't think that whatever I'm wearing now fits the vlog. So let me change first and then let's go. Sure. So, yep, I think this suits for our Egyptian tour for today. So come on, join me and let's learn. So, without further much ado, let's start with the geography. Without the Nile River, all of Egypt would be desert. Only about an inch of rain falls throughout Egypt each year. But each summer, the river rises because of rains at its source far to the south in Ethiopia. Floods cover the river's valleys, leaving sediments needed for trees, plants, and crops to grow. Southern Egypt's landscape contains low mountains and desert. Northern Egypt has wide valleys near the Nile and desert to the east and west. North of Cairo, the capital, is the sprawling triangular Nile River Delta. This fertile land is completely covered with farms. Now, let's move on to people and culture of Egypt. About 90% of Egyptians are Muslims, which means they are followers of Islamic religion. About 10% of Egyptians are Copts. It's the one of the oldest branches of the Christian religion. Egypt's population is growing rapidly. This puts strains on Egypt's resources, since most people live in a narrow strip of land along the Nile River. Having so many people in such a small area can cause overcrowding, from schools to apartment buildings to hospitals. So, children are highly valued in Egypt, especially in rural areas where they help on family farms. Children are also expected to look after their parents in their old age. And now, let's go to the nature in Egypt. Egypt is home to a wide variety of animals and plants, including jackals, gazelles, crocodiles, and cobras. The best places to see Egypt's wildlife are in its more than 20 protected regions, which include oases, deserts, mountains, coastal areas, river islands, and wetlands. Egyptians have always been close to the natural world. The ancient Egyptians left paintings and carvings of large animals like elephants, hippos, leopards, and cheetahs. These animals were once common in Egypt, but they are now rare or extinct because of hunting and habitat loss. And now, we are on the tourist destination. So, I will present you a total of six Egypt or Egypt's tourist destination, and let me share a little background about them. Egypt has so much for travelers to see and do. It's the perfect country for a mix of activities combining culture, adventure, and relaxation. Now, let's begin. The last surviving of the seven wonders of the ancient world, the pyramids of Giza, are one of the world's most recognizable landmarks. Built as tombs for the mighty pharaohs and guarded by an enigmatic sphinx, Giza's pyramid complex has awed travelers down through the ages and has archaeologists scratching their heads over how they were built for centuries. Today, these megalithic memorials to dead kings are still as wondrous a sight as they ever were. An undeniable highlight of any Egypt trip, Giza's pyramids should not be missed. And now, we are in the Egyptian Museum, a treasure above of the pharaonic world Kairos Egyptian Museum is one of the world's great museums collections. The faded pink mansion is home to a dazzling amount of exhibits. It's a place with little labeling on after and not much chronological order, but does have of its old school charm. Upstairs is the Golden Glory of King and the fascinating Royal Mummies exhibits. But really, every corner you should turn here is home to some wonderful piece of Asian art or statuary that would form a highlight of any other museum. The third one is the White Desert. Egypt's cookiest natural wonder is the White Desert, where surreally shaped chalk mountains have created what looks like a snowy wonderland in the middle of the arid sand. The landscapes here look like something out of science fiction movie, with blindingly white boulders and iceberg-like pinnacles. For desert fans and adventurers, this is the ultimate weird playground, while anybody who's had their fill of temples and tombs will enjoy this spectacular natural scenery. We are on our fourth one, which is St. Catherine's Monastery. It's one of the most oldest monastery in the world. St. Catherine stands at the foot of Mount Sinai, where Moses is said to have received the Ten Commandments. This desert monastery is home to an incredible collection of religious iconography art and manuscripts, as well as the burning bush. For most visitors here, a trip to St. Catherine's also involves a hike up Mount Sinai to see sunrise or sunset. Take the camel path for the easy route or climb the famous steps of Representance if you want better views. And now we were on our fifth one, and it is the Abydos Temple. Does the Abydos town wouldn't make much of a rating on the tourism radar if it wasn't for the incredible temple on its doorstep? Abydos Temple of Osiris is one of the ancient Egypt's most fascinating artistic treasures. Its chunky columns and walls covered in beautiful hieroglyphics and indicate paintings are spellbinding sights. And even better, you can admire them without the crowds as despite its dazzling beauty. It receives few visitors compared to the temples in nearby Luxor. Aichar, it's not yet over. So, for our last tourist destination in the country Egypt, we have Tisselgorm Dive Site. Below the Red Sea surface is another world as fascinating as the temples and tombs on land. Among the many coral reefs off the coast, there's also a glut of shipwrecks that have sunk in the Red Sea's Gulf of Gubal and Gulf of Aqaba. Of all the wrecks, the most famous is the Tisselgorm, an English World War II cargo ship that was on its way to resupply British troops when it was bombed by the Germans in 1941. Today, the site is regarded by divers as one of the top 5 wreck dives in the world due to the vast cargo of cars, motorbikes, and World War II memorabilia that can be seen both scattered on the seabed, around the wreck, and inside the ship itself. Dive boat trips to the wreck are organized from both Sharm el-Sheikh and Huqaba. So, that's all for today! Thank you for staying with me. And this is Thea, your new Cleopatra of this century. So goodbye and thank you for watching. I hope you learn something. So see you in my next vlog. Bye!